day. We can do anything, anything, anything. And all our dreams light up the way. We can have everything, everything, everything.
Hello student, good morning. Most welcome to the Rita Das classes. I request all the new viewers to please subscribe my channel. Today I am going to teach you the fourth lesson of class 9. The topic is A Truly Beautiful Mind. And first of all, we have to know about the introduction of the lesson. A Truly Beautiful Mind is a brief biographical sketch of the great genius Albert Einstein. It gives the readers a glimpse into his early life and his contribution to the world of science. Einstein was a visionary who never went with the flow but charted his own path once he knew that he was right. He was not afraid of being at odds with anyone, including his teachers. He was a strong man who stuck to his principles and ideas. After knowing the introduction, we have to know about the author. Albert Einstein, who was born on 14th March 1879, Ulm, in Germany, and he was a Princeton, New Jersey, U.S., German-born scientist who developed the special and general theories of relativity and won the Nobel Prize for Physics in 1921. For his explanation of the photoelectric effect, Einstein is generally considered the most influential physicist of the 20th century. After knowing the author, we have to know the difficult words. And dear students, I have collected difficult words. You have to screenshot it and note down in your copy and learn it. Now, the chapter started with the Einstein. Albert Einstein, who was born on 14th March 1879 in the German city of Ulm. Since his childhood, he was alone and had no friends to play with. And his mother thought he was a freak child because his head was also very large and he did not speak until at the age of 2.5. And when he started speaking, he used to say twice the things. He always liked the mechanical toys to play with. When his sister's Maza was born, that time he asked his mother where his sister's will was. And from the very beginning of his childhood, he was a very poor child. He did not take interest in the study also. So once the headmasters of a school said to his parents that whatever he would take the subjects in the future in his life, he would never succeed. So that no matter what career Einstein would choose, he will never successful. His headmaster used to say, his playmates used to say him as a brother boring, and he did not know what to do with the friends. He started playing the violin at the age of 6 because his mother wanted to become a great violinist, and he also get success in the field of the violin. And the school of at the age of the 15, he was feeling stifled. He had hated the, and at the higher secondary time, he went to the and get the admission in the Munich. And there he did not like the regimentation and the rule of the school, and because there were always the clash between the teachers and with him, an argument was going on between him and the teacher. So at last he felt the stifled in the school environment, and so he left the school. His parents had moved to the Milan and left him a Munich with his relatives. He got to the continue his education in the city. Much more liberal than Munich, he was interested in physics and was highly gifted in mathematics also. He studied at the university in Zurich. There he fell in love with a lady named Maliva, whom he felt was a clever creature. At the age of 21, he was a university graduate but unemployed. He worked as a teaching assistant and gave private lessons. He secured a job in 1902 as a technical expert in Bern. While assisting others, he was also busy finding out his own theories and doing various experiments. In 1905, one of the famous papers was Einstein's special theory of relativity, according to which time and distance are not absolute. He also derived the world's most famous formula that describes the relation between the mass and energy. And Einstein wanted to marry Maliva after finishing his studies, but his mother did not want to give approval. But because his mother thought that Maliva was too old for him and was a book, like a book for the Einstein. At last, he got married with Maliva in 1903 and had two sons. Unfortunately, the marriage life not success and they divorced in the year 1919. Later, Einstein married his cousins Elsa the same year in 1921. He received Nobel Prize for Physics for the relativity theory. Einstein feared that the Nazis could build an atom bomb for destructive purpose to gain superpower. So he wrote a letter to American President Franklin Roosevelt to warn him about the impact of the atomic bomb. But instead, the American developed the atomic bomb in a secret project and dropped the bomb on the Japanese city, causing the large-scale destruction in Hiroshima and Nagasaki. Einstein was shocked and shaken by the bombing. What he feared came true. His letter to be president had an undesired effect. So he urged United Nations to make a world government, but it had so impact. He did not lose confidence, and over the decades, he traveled worldwide to campaign for peace and democracy. Einstein died at the age of 76 in the year 1955. But till date, he is celebrated as a visionary and world citizen and is accepted by the world as a scientific genius. After the explanation, we have to know about the summary of the lesson. A truly beautiful mind, the chapter about the Albert Einstein. The title of the chapter, A Truly Beautiful Mind, refers to the Albert Einstein as he was a great scientist. Moreover, the chapter is a short biography of his, where they highlight some of the qualities. Also, the chapter shows Albert's interest in mathematics and physics and his ordinary human attribute. However, the title, A Truly Beautiful Mind, may let you wonder how a scientist's mind can be beautiful. It is because this lesson can be maybe let you wonder how a scientist's mind can be beautiful, and we get to know about another aspects of his life, his other side, that he believes in humanity. Moreover, he advocates world peace, non-violence his entire life. That's why the title refers to him, A Truly Beautiful Mind. After the summary, we have to know the theme of the story. This brief sketch of the life and achievements of the great genius and visionary Albert Einstein reveals that great men are not necessarily noticed during the early years. Einstein come across as a fairly ordinary person who has his likes and dislikes. His streaks of rebellion and his problems, the author focuses on two aspects of Einstein's personality. And as a scientist, as a human being, Albert Einstein, the scientist, is the best known for his path breaking discoveries, Albert Einstein, the humanitarian, is known for the pacifism and political activism as he worked for peace and democracy in the world. At last, the conclusion of the lesson that a truly beautiful mind possesses not only the vision but also for the well-being of mankind. Science should be solely devoted to the promotion of world peace and prosperity. If used for destructive purposes, the scientific invention and discoveries can wreak havoc on the humanities. Thank you.